Hello and welcome to our new online learning session, KNX Daily Gateway Premium, with the topic Color Function Human-Centric Lighting HCL. In this online learning session, we would like to inform you about a dedicated topic. So it takes around half an hour, so 30 minutes. So the focus is not on a general topic, but on a very specific topic. And today the topic is human-centric lighting with our new Daily Gateways DGS X6451. My name is Thorsten Reibel. I'm starting today, but together with me, not here in my home office, but online, is Jürgen Schilder, who will take care of another part of this session. So, what is planned for today? So, the topic is human-centric lighting with our new DALI gateways. As you know, we are all working in our home office. So, you see myself and Jürgen, but also Martin Vichari. Martin will also come in the next week with some topics. And here you see Stefan Grosse, who is also working from his home, partly to help in any technical issues. So, what is the agenda for today? Human-centric lighting, as already mentioned. So, we are talking in details about this technology inside our new DALI gateways. So I will start with a general introduction. What is human-centric lighting at all? What applications, which projects are behind? And then Jürgen will continue with a detailed explanation of the commissioning of this function, together with the ETS, of course, with the ETS parameters, the group objects, and of course also the assignment of group addresses. And a further part is, of course, our ABB IBAS tool, which is an essential part of our new DALI gateways for programming, but also for testing and so on. So, as mentioned, it's part of our relatively new components, the DALI Gateway Premium, DGS 1 or 2, 6451. We have launched these products in February this year. So they are now available with a lot of new functions, but in principle, it's based on the existing DALI basic components we have already some years. So, with the same functions, we have also two components as one or two channels. So, up to 64 ballasts can be connected to one channel with a two-fold device, up to 128 ballasts in total. So, on which kind of DALI ballasts can be connected? You might remember the different DALI device types. So, we have so-called normal DALI ballasts, device type 0, of course, can be connected. And then also the single battery emergency lighting converter called device type 1 can be also integrated. We have complete software functionality for emergency lighting integrated for testing and monitoring and so on. And what is new, we can connect now also our color-controlled DALI ballast, device type 8. And at the moment, we are concentrating on tunable white, so on the change of the color temperature. So all the functions we had already in the basic components are still existing. So the flexible combination of DALI groups or single control of individual ballasts is possible. Of course, the ABB IBAS tool support. We have these templates to simplify or to have a more economic programming than available in the ETS. And the main topic is the main new topic is the tunable white functions. And last week we were talking already about the dim to warm function and also about the standby shutdown, not directly tunable white, but also an essential function. And today our topic is human-centric lighting. So what is human-centric lighting at all? Sunlight is essential for health and well-being. And at the moment, it's very sunny here in the middle of Europe and Germany. So we are really enjoying the sun outside. But if we are working inside in our home or in our offices or wherever in the hospitals, of course, we have no normal sunlight. And the target is to simulate the sunlight, which you have normally only outside, inside the room. To have the same positive effects when you are outside under sun. So it improves your mood, it improves the activity you can do, your motivation will be improved as well. And also in any working areas, your productivity and concentration is much better. Yeah, it's very important, of course, because we are spending a lot of time in our rooms, in our houses. And of course, if we can improve the situation regarding lighting inside, it's of course much better for our well-being as well. So the principle is, you see it here on the right side, it's a curve. We simulate in principle the behavior of the daylight inside the room, means we change over the day the color temperature. And this curve represents in principle the situation. So we start in the morning with a very low color temperature, means warm white. And over the day, it's getting not only brighter, but also colder in terms of color temperature, means it's getting a colder white. And in the afternoon, it goes down again to a warmer white. And that's a typical situation outside. And that's what we are in principle simulating inside the room. So low color temperature means warm white, and higher color temperature means cold white. Yeah. So this can be automated directly inside our new Daily Gateways Premium. Yeah. So this is only the change of the color temperature. Of course, in more complex HCL heating, sorry, human-centric lighting systems, not only the color temperature, but also the brightness, maybe the light distribution in the room, the direction of the light can be verified, varied. So we can also simulate even more than the color temperature if needed. Yeah. So if additionally necessary, you can also create some special, let me say, light scenes. So in case of any activities at a machine in the production hall, you can say, okay, I need now very bright and very high color temperature light, though it's in the morning or in the evening. And of course, this can be done additionally. So more or less, you override then the typical curve shown here on the right side. Some project examples. You see here a situation in a school, so educational institutions, where you might have normally over the day the automatic human-centric lighting, with a curve I have shown already. But of course, you can take also actions like individual control. So maybe in the morning, you say, no, I need very cold color temperature for high concentration because there's any examination. Yeah, then you start any scene, for example. Yeah. Over the normal, let me say, learning hours, you have the normal HCL curve. And maybe during relaxation, during the breaks, for example, reduce again the color temperature to a very warm white for quite good relaxation of the students inside the classroom. Or here, typical situation in offices. Yeah, where you have, of course, also these typical positive effects of the HCL curve. So improving your vitality during the day. Or you say, okay, during any conference, you would like to have much more concentration of the people. So you increase the color temperature to blue-white lighting, for example. Yeah. And all these things have a positive effect to the biorhythm of the people, which also improves your sleeping situation. This is also something which has a positive effect here. So in hospitals, a big topic at the moment, we know why. So how is the situation here? Yeah, patients, but also people working there spend a lot of time in the hospital. Yeah, and they cannot go out normally, and especially patients which are ill, which are lying on the bed, are not able to go outside. So if you simulate the natural light, of course, this has a very positive effect of the patients, especially mentally ill people. Yeah, maybe need some less medicine, for example, but also the people who are working there, of course, nurses and doctors, get an improvement of their well-being together with HCL lighting. Yeah, then in the industry, you see on the right side any ABB factory. It's also a positive effect for the productivity of the people. Less errors and accidents might happen with the right lighting situation. Yeah. And also here you can use light scenes if you have to work in a very concentrated way at a machine in case of any failure, for example. And think about shift workers, people who are working also during the night. In principle, you can simulate also the daylight during the night to have a better well-being for the workers. So you see a lot of interesting and positive effects in different applications. This is all possible with human-centric lighting. So I would hand over now to Jürgen. Jürgen will continue now with a more detailed explanation how to implement this into our new gateways and what has to be done there. Just a moment.
Hello and welcome. Jürgen Schilder is speaking. Thanks, Thorsten, for your introduction. Before we come to the commissioning, I would like to show you what is basically required for human-centric lighting controlling. At first, our heart is our DALI KNX Gateway Premium DGS X6451. We need some control elements and of course a KNX power supply and device type 8 DALI ballast. So device type 8 means with these devices we can control special tunable white spots or LED strips. Like here on the right side, you can see typically tunable white spots here from a manufacturer constantly. This is what we use here in our training. Here you can see we can dim the color temperature between 2200 and 6500 Kelvin. So from very warm white to up to cold white. Or here a typical LED strip. You see here the warm white LED and the cold white LED. And here the three wires. One is the common, one is for warm white, and the other one is for cold white. And depending on the DALI commands from our premium gateway, the ballast mix now the cold and the warm white. So these are the typical hardware, the minimum hardware we need to do here our human-centric lighting. So now first we start with setting the parameters and the groups or in the ballast. And then in the second step, we come to the parameters and the output. Here this is an overview what we have to do. At first we go to the groups of ballast, we enable our color temperature. Yeah, we set some parameters, for example, when we have KNX voltage recovery and so on. And now I show you all these steps now. I show you all the things now in steps by step. So at first we start here in our group or in the ballast. So we go to the ETS parameter and we go here to the menu group or ballast. So very important with the human-centric lighting, we control the color temperature between cold white and warm white, but we don't have influence on the brightness, like on the dimming value. For example, this is another step we can do, for example, so we can activate both a constant light control system together here with HCL. This is still possible. Good, let's start here in our group of ballast. We have two possibilities. We can use here our templates, which really helps us during the commissioning to save time, or you can do it in the individual groups or in the individual ballast. So now if we want to use the color function, we have to go to the submenu color temperature, and then on the right side we have the parameter use color temperature function, no color temperature function, central color temperature, our HCL, or we can use dim to warm. So now the DALI gateway offers two color functions, the dim to warm or our human-centric lighting. And then we have to decide per group or per ballast, do we use the dim to warm or do we use the HCL? So in our case, we want to use here our HCL. So we select here the parameter use HCL. So and then we get some more parameters. So the next parameter is the state after KNX recovery or after a download via the ETS. We have three possibilities. We can select or we can keep the default parameter like before. And then after KNX bus voltage comebacks, we have the same situation like before. Was the HCL activated or deactivated? We have the same after bus voltage recovery. Or it should be activated or deactivated. These are the three parameters. So in the next step, we come to the parameters. For example, when the HCL is activated in our group or in a ballast, and the group or the ballast receives a color temperature value. For example, we have the communication object, like here my group number one, set color temperature. So we are a control element or we are time switch, it's possible to send here a color temperature value. Then we can set here parameter how should now this group react? One default is ignore. So he the color function remains active and this value he has received is now ignored. Or we can say no, the higher priority is to deactivate the HCL function and he should adapt this color temperature value. Next parameter is similar, but now here when he receives a dim color temperature value, via control element we can change our color temperature like dimming. Dimming is normally up and down the brightness, but via the group object, group number one, for example, dim color temperature, it's a 4-bit, we can dim the color temperature between warm and cold white. And here again, the behavior, ignore if he receives here a telegram or value, or deactivate the function and adapt this value. And the third parameter, what happens if the color function is activated and a scene is called, like a typical 8-bit scene between 1 and 64, should the color function remains and say, okay, I don't listen to the value of the scene, or the scene should be deactivated and follow to the color temperature and the brightness value. But these are the three parameters, for example, when he receives here telegrams or values via the individual group objects. Good, and then we come to the complete output. So we know we go to the main menu, to our main parameter, like here output A or output B, and to the menu color functions. So here we have the possibility to enable or block a so-called group object activate automatic HCL per complete output. The default is no. When we say yes, and then we get here a group object like for output A, it's the object number 64. We see here output A activate automatic HCL color function, yes or no. So via 1-bit telegram, we can activate the HCL for all ballast which are parameterized for HCL on the output. It's also additional function. Good, so far these are the main settings. How we can now activate or deactivate the HCL functions. We can do it per group or per ballast. So when we go to a group or ballast and we activate the HCL function, then we get additionally the object, like here, group number one, activate automatic HCL color function. So we are the value one, we can activate it for group number one or for all the other groups. Or here, when we use individual ballast, like here my ballast number three, I get also here object to activate it per ballast. And what is also possible, remember the slide before, when we enable the object for complete output A, then we can also activate it here via the logical one, and then the HCL color function is activated for all ballast centrally in my output number 8. Activated or deactivated when we send a 0. So far these parameters. So and then we come to an important slide. The DALI gateway needs the source of the color temperature. And now we have two possibilities. We can say, okay, the DALI gateway, the source is now the internal value, so called our ramp curve. So we can create an internal ramp with a starting point, yeah, and a final point and transition time. And the same, for example, here down. Or we can say no, we want, or the DALI gateway should listen to an external color temperature value, maybe which comes, for example, here from a BMS system or from a visualization system. That's what we have to set per output. So this is important. Like output A, for example, we can use the internal ramp, and if you want, output B, for example, can use here the external. So this is the possibility. Now let me start. For example, here with the overview, we can use the external value, which is a 16-byte value, which is calculated by a BMS or visualization, or the internal 1-bit function. So, and we can do it per ballast or we set it per the output if we want to use here the 16-bit or the 1-bit. Now let me start with the 16-bit external value. So then the complete output A is listening to the 60-byte object. So all ballasts and groups which are connected here to output A follows exactly this 16-byte external value. So now we go here to our color functions, output A, and we click here on this button, 16-bit group object color temperature. And then here listening to this external value. So we need a visualization system or BMS system. He calculates, depending maybe on the time and date and the location of the building, yeah, where it is in which country, and so on. He calculates the color temperature value, send it as a 2-byte value to KNX, and our DALI gateway, the output A, is listening to this value. So, and then we get here automatically a group object, which is the number 63 for output A, HCL color temperature 2-byte value. And then when it's activated, the balanced or the groups follows exactly here this color temperature value. So we can set a special time, so-called transition time. So when he receives now the value until he adapts the new temperature value of our lamp. Typically, for example, here 20 T-seconds. So in the IBAS tool, our diagnostic software, we can also see the color function, which color function is now selected. Like here, for example, the HCL is here selected for this group or the ballast, and if the color function is activated or deactivated. So these two information we can also see here in our IBAS tool. So on this slide here, you can see the overview, what we need. First, the DALI gateway, DALI device type 8, our tunable white LED spots, power adapter. Then we need also a control element to control our groups, switch, dims and values, and to activate our automatic HCL. This is a 1-bit telegram. So plus our BMS system or visualization system, which sends here our 16-bit color temperature to our DALI gate. That is what we need in this case. So here for a small demonstration, what we need on hardware, if we want to do it in a typical practical exercise, we need the group, or I use, for example, the ETS group monitor to send this 2-byte calculated value. So with the ETS group monitor, I simulate the visualization system, my BMS, and here with one group, with one control element, with output A, I activate the HCL for the complete output. The next rocker, I call a scene, and with rocker number 4, I can activate it or deactivate it per group, like group number 1. And with the second rocker, I switch, dim my group number 1, I set a color temperature, and I can dim the color temperature. So this is a typical example in a training. And now, how we have to link the group objects, you will see it's not difficult. Like here on the left side, I have my DALI gateway, and on the right side, I have my control elements. So at first, I with the control element number 2, I want to switch, dim, yeah, and send also, for example, here values to my group number 1. This is the group number 1 to link here the objects, 1 bit for switching, 4 bit for dimming. I link here the LED status to see it here on the LEDs and the brightness value and so on. So for changing the color temperature with rocker number 3, I can send, for example, here a value, the 2-byte value to change the color temperature, or to change here the color temperature we are dimming. So this is basically nothing to do at the moment with HCL. And here with this rocker, I can call here, for example, scene, left side scene number 10, right side number 12 for D1. So now for activation of our color function, I have the possibility to send a 1-bit object to the output A, and then all ballasts and groups, the color function is activated. Or I can send here with the rocker number 4 a telegram to output to my group number 1, group number 2, to activate the color function or deactivate it per group or per ballast. So these are two possibilities, per group or ballast, or for the complete output. And the last telegram comes from our BMS system or visualization system. Like here, I simulated via the ETS group monitor to send here the HCL color temperature. And now when the HCL is activated, the ballast and the groups are listening here to this 2-byte value. Good, so far, this is a solution when we say listen to an external value from a visualization system, BMS. Or the second solution is we say, no, we use the internal value, a so-called our ramp. And then we select here the parameter HCL color temperature source, 1-bit object ramp. This is the second possibility. Now here on the parameters, we have an internal ramp function with a typically initial start temperature value and a final color temperature value. These are the settings here. And via external device, like for example time switch or our, for example, TIA, our time receiver, we can trigger the ramp via a one-bit function. So this is also possible. So the ramp is internal, stored in DALI gateway, and we trigger the ramp from outside via a KNX telegram. So here in the ETS parameter, we can set our initial color temperature for starting of the ramp, like for example, in the morning, 2700 Kelvin, and then maybe in the afternoon, he goes up to 6000 Kelvins in a transition time of 7200 seconds. I think these are 2 hours. So when we send a telegram, start the ramp, we start with this value, and after 2 hours, he reaches our value of 6000 Kelvins. Then when we want to fall the ramp, we send again a KNX telegram, and then he goes from 6000 Kelvin to 2700 Kelvin in the time, again, for example, here of 2 hours. So these are the values we set here and the ETS parameter. So we can see it here on the right side, the picture. So in the ETS, we set here our values, our initial color temperature value, and then we have to send the value 0 to this object, HCL ramp up and down. 0, maybe, which comes from a time switch or our time receiver, send in the morning a 0. And then when the function is activated, our groups and ballast jumps to our initial value, starts with 3000 Kelvin, and then he goes until the time, for example here 4 hours, to our value, final value, color temperature end value of here 4500. Then he stays on this value, and then maybe in the afternoon, 3 o'clock, via a time switch, we have to send the value 1, and then the ramp goes down to our final color temperature value, maybe to 2700. So the group address is still the same, only depending on the value. Via 0, we trigger the ramp up, and via the value 1, we trigger the ramp down. This is the meaning. So what is also possible, that we have different initial color temperature values, maybe for starting the ramp. For example, here is 3000 Kelvin up to 4500. And for going the ramp down, we can say no, start at 5000, maybe here to 2700. So now what happens? We start the ramp in the morning, he jumps between 5 seconds to 3000, and then over 4 hours to 4500, we stay at 4500, and then when we send the value 1, between 5 seconds he goes to the new value, 5000, and then he goes down to 2700. And in the morning, we continue here on the left side again with 2700 until he receives the value 0 for ramp up. So it's also possible. So now what happens if the HCL is deactivated, but the ramp is still running in the background? So now the ramp runs, and then the ramp is, for example, triggered here. The ramp is running, and then we switch the light here on, and then he goes automatically to the value he has at the moment here on the ramp. It's also possible between 5 seconds. Good, and here you can see the complete overview, including the parameters on the right side. At first, we have here our temperature values for the ramp, for the rising ramp or ramp up, like 3000 Kelvin to 4500 Kelvins. So we start, for example, here up to 4500. And here our transition time about 4 hours. Then he stays this value, and then we start here from 4500, ramp down to our 2700 here in 5 hours, which are 18,000 seconds. And via the group object HCL ramp up and down, we can trigger here the ramp up with the value 0, and here with the value 1, the ramp down. So these are the parameters we have here. Good, and in the IBUS tool, we can still see the same similar like before. We can see that the HCL color function now is selected, is used, and if the HCL color function is now active or not. Good, and here also a small example. What do we need? We need, of course, the DALI gateway, our DALI device type 8 ballast. We need a sensor to activate or deactivate the HCL per complete output, or per group, per ballast. And we need a device to trigger our ramp up or a ramp down. For example, it can be time switch or our time receiver GPS. He knows exactly the time and day depending on his position, and can send the 1-bit telegram, ramp up, value 0, or ramp down, value 1. Good, a small exercise you can do in a practical training. We need again DALI gateway, our DT8 ballast. We need a one group element, one control element to switch and dim or change the color temperature of our group number 1. So our two ballasts are here linked in the group number 1. And we need one group element, one control element to activate HCL per complete output. Next one for scene control. And for example here to simulate our ramp up and down, which is our time receiver or time switch. We can use here the rocker number 3 and with rocker number 4 to activate the automatic HCL per group. Rocker number 4 per group and rocker number 1 per complete output. Good, and here again, how to link the group addresses. Similar like before, with the control element number 2, we use it for switching and dimming our group number 1. And with rocker number 3 and 4, we set the color temperature value and we dim the color temperature up and down. That is like before. So with rocker number 2 of our another control element, we can call a scene. And with rocker number 1, we link the group address with rocker number 1 to the object of the complete output to activate the color function in all our ballast of output A, or with rocker number 4, we can activate or deactivate the color function per group, like here my group number 1. Now, what we still need is, for example, our rocker number 3. He simulates our external time switch or time receiver and triggers here our ramp. So we link this group address to the group object HCL ramp up and down. Remember, 1 is down and up is 0. This is similar like the values we use it for controlling shutters. Good, these are the parameters and the objects how we have to link the group addresses. Good, so far the commissioning and our group objects, and now I hand back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. So let's let's summarize the main features of this component together with human-centric lighting. So we can adapt the people's daily rhythm together with human-centric lighting to increase the motivation and the well-being and the productivity. So in principle, we simulate, of course, the daylight in the rooms, in the building, and how to implement this HCL color function. In principle, you can have an external source to send the right value at the right time, to have the right color temperature at the right time. Or you start the internal ramp we have seen, which makes it very easy to implement this without any external device. You can activate and deactivate per group, per ballast, or also centrally for the whole device and all connected ballasts behind. And what is necessary, of course, is a DALI device type 8 and DALI ballasts and, of course, tunable white LEDs are required as well. As always, a short summary of all the other things we have. Our homepage, of course, for each product you find there all the dedicated information. Of course, also for the new DALI gateways premium. We have our training database with a lot of more stuff around DALI and also these components. There we store also these online learning sessions, the videos, and also the presentations very soon. But you get the feedback email, of course, of all these 3 sessions we have done today and also the last week. Our training calendar, as you know, we have all our trainings, training dates there. You will see what happens in the next future with presence trainings, but also here our webinars will be will be shown as well. We still plan for the second half of the year with presence training. We'll see what is possible. For your information, we have always over the year these certified trainings, which maybe can be continued in July with the advanced course. We will see. We have done already in February the basic course, which was still possible. But wait on further information. We will keep you updated during our sessions and our webinars, what's going on there. And our next webinar, again, around the DALI Gateway Premium, will be on the 6th of May. And then we more or less summarize the main features, the 3 features we have done already in the online sessions, human-centric lighting, dim to warm, and standby switch off. But we go also to some more details of scenes, for example, and also of the IBAS tool that we would like to show a bit more. So it might be partly a concentrated summary of these three online sessions, but I think not everybody could join during these days or online sessions, so I think it's worth to talk about this again with some more further details. So 6th of May in the morning and in the afternoon, as always. Good. Any further questions at the moment? So we still keep the chat open to answer your final questions, or if you have some more, don't hesitate and send it to us. And otherwise, I say thank you to all of you. Thank you to Jürgen. He did the main part today. And
Thorsten, please
sorry,
the next slide.
I missed something. Thank you, Jürgen. Yeah, of course, we have further online sessions, online learning sessions. So we continue still this week on Thursday. Not with a DALI Gateway preview anymore, so we have finished this in our online learning sessions. But we talk about a more general topic, KNX ETS5. The programming software and group addresses. So there are some interesting and special, let me say, features behind, not completely new, so-called free style address structure, importing and exporting of addresses. You can save a lot of time in big projects to work the right way here. And Jürgen will explain everything with some examples. I think it's a good additional topic we can do. So it will be on Thursday. Again in the morning and in the afternoon. Then we continue. We have planned at the moment more online sessions starting at the 28th of April. Control touch will be the topic twice. And then the topic presence detector. Neither a new component, but there are a lot of questions all the time about calibration, constant light control, about the master-slave concept. It's always an issue. And this will be done by Martin, and he will take care of this topic a bit more. But again, we will continue with even more online learning sessions, but this will be then, the information about this will be issued a bit later. Okay, I think this was really the last slide for today. So thank you for your participation. See you next time. Ciao and bye-bye.